Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, praise, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed will be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is on earth. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Almighty Elohim, here is another end at eight, not an end, but a beginning at the 8 o'clock. Hallelujah, intercession. I want to thank you, Father. Hallelujah. I thank you for your, for giving us the strength. I thank you, Father, for keeping us healthy. I thank you, Father, for being on our minds all day long. I thank you, Father, hallelujah, for your great work. I thank you, Father, that the earth is full of your glory. I thank you, Father, that you put your glory in us. I thank you, Father, hallelujah, for the green grass that we recognize and walk on. I thank you, Father, for the beautiful trees you made, fruit trees and all kinds of trees with magnolia flowers on it, and apple trees and peach trees. I thank you for the flowers that you've made that we could have the sweet smells in this earth. I thank you for the sweet sounds of our children's voices. Hallelujah, that just bless us and bless us and bless us. I thank you for the sound of the voices of our friends. Hallelujah. I thank you for the sound of the voices of our neighbors and people we work with and people we've gone to school with. We just want to thank you this evening, Father. Hallelujah. We thank you for your voice. And ooh, we just thank you for your joy. We thank you for your strength. We thank you for giving us wisdom. We thank you for continuing to encourage us all along the way. Hallelujah. We know you don't ever give up on us, because look at us. Hallelujah. You never fail us. You never leave us. You never forsake us. Sometimes we forsake you, but you don't ever forsake us. And I want to thank you for that. And I want to thank you for all the people that you saved today, for all the people that you healed today. I want to bless you and thank you. Now, Father, I ask you to forgive us of all our sins. Hallelujah. Forgive us for anything known and unknown, any anything that we didn't do. We want clean records again. Some of us have been out in the world. Hallelujah. And some of those evil spirits was watching us and looking at us and trying to trip us up, but they failed because you were watching them. So we thank you, Father. And now, Father, I want to thank you again for breakfast of fast this morning. And we just ask you to continue, Father, to touch our sister Charisse's body, her heart, her soul, her mind, give her strength in the innermost depth in her blood cell and her spiritual, the spiritual atmosphere around her. We just ask, Father, that if there's any cloud anywhere trying to even come in somewhere, the adversary done said, now you go try some old Father, send your word and disperse everything. Just keep her in that place where the atmosphere and the frequencies are moving back and forth from heaven to her body, to her family, and same thing for Brian. Do the same thing, Father, with his body, with his bones, with his joints, with the marrow, hallelujah, and all those words inside of all the people, and with Bethany, and the word inside of all of them and inside of us. Our bones, our marrow and our bones, whatever each individual one's body need from you, I pray that you grant it, and I know that you're granting it, and I know that a change is taking place in our body, even the chemistry in our body, hallelujah, and the fluids in our body. And Father, that breakfast guarantee that there are toxins that's continuing to leave our bodies and being flushed out. Hallelujah. And Father, I pray more water, that all of us are drinking more water. So we thank you for straightening our bones. We thank you for taking away arthritis and bursitis and all them other itis. We want to thank you for taking away itches that people have in what's that, Father? Whatever that, I can't think of the name of it, but it itches people. Oh my goodness. Anyway, it'll come to me, Father. Give it to me, though, what I'm trying to say. Shingles. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, we pray for those that have shingles, and we pray for healing, from shingles, and we pray for healing of spiritual situations. We pray that you clear that atmosphere of all that whispering. We will not receive the whispers in our mind and in our soul. So we just ask again, and I'm going to let somebody else go, health in the whole household. We call a whole household healthy, delivered. Hallelujah. And that when people feel that uncomfortable, they'll say, my body is healed. My body is whole. I have a healthy body. I have a healthy mind. Hallelujah. I put this in there, you all. And the finances are coming, and my children are reconciled to me, and my children are talking to me, and grandmothers and granddaughters and all that. We're all talking together. We're calling things that are not as though they were. We have an abundance of blessing poured out upon us. We are giving. We are giving from what we have to give. If we only have $5, we giving 10% of that. I think that's 10, what is 10, whatever, 5 cents, 50 cents. We thank you that we are planting seeds. And if we don't have anything to plant, we are planting good things into people's lives. We are sharing our smiles. We are sharing your wisdom and encouragement. So, Father, let the atmosphere be full where all the people that are ill, those that are not ill, or those that are feeling unwell, because these bones, these legs, these are ankles, these feet belong to you. Any of your people, if they name it Yeshua, Yahshua, Yahushua, Yahusha, or Jesus, or Lord, or Yah, or Yahuwah, Yahuwah, hallelujah, then, Father, they got your word in their hands, I pray, hallelujah, flood them with the healing power, blessing bread and water, and taking discomfort out of not only the mist, out of their bodies, their hearts, their soul, their mind, out of their thinking pattern, because thoughts are very powerful. And you're saying it, and then your thought is not, you might think about somebody and you just think about they don't feel well all the time, and you got to get that thought out of your brain and ask Father to put a way down in there. But Father has healed them. Father has healed us. Okay, let me let somebody else go. Blessings upon you all, and we are praying the word all the time, and that is what is making all the difference. The word is going up. Hallelujah. Father's own word that say, be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. Do not be afraid. Hallelujah. I hear you. If you love me, keep my sayings. If you love me, keep my word. And you can go to the Father, and I will grant whatever it is that you are asking me. And then Father means it when he said, where two or more are gathered in my name, there am I in the midst of you. He means that. That's why he put that there. And he said it's there. So it don't take a whole congregation. Hallelujah. 100,000 people, 100 or more people. It takes 2 or 3 people trying to obey me, pushing and pressing toward the goal of the high call of Yahushua. I just want to thank you. Hallelujah. For your word. All right. I'm going to let somebody else go here. Cause I done took a, okay. Somebody grab the mic with your holy, holy mouth. Hallelujah. So we can agree. I'm done. Somebody else can go. Hallelujah.
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 This is Sister Bethany. Yesterday I was very happy with I tried to reach the phone. Okay, I'm ready. I was really happy. I don't know, just being on the prayer line yesterday, I loved hearing the joy and happiness. It just seemed like a lot yesterday, and I couldn't really make any comments from yesterday, but I'm just blessed with what I heard last night. I'm very happy. And I love how people on here are, you know, really trying to help their friends in ways that have to do with the scriptures. I really like that. I like how everybody is trying to, you know, when they hear people wanting to divorce or people wanting to, you know, do things they shouldn't, but I'm seeing people bring them to the word, no, sister, or no, brother, this is what you need to be doing. But also I like how all of us are trying to make sure that we are doing right as well, so we are not hypocrites to our friends or our family. And I'm just so thankful, so happy. And I definitely get an education from Home of Prayer, and I'm just very appreciative of that. I'm very appreciative of the support that everyone gives to one another. That is such a blessing. I mean, I can't even see you guys, and I can see you, if that makes any sense. I'm just very grateful. Thank you, Father, so much for the people that you have in my life, and thank you so much for the testimonies and the good things that have happened in this congregation. Husbands being, you know, reunited with wives, and people changing their mind about, you know, divorce, and it's just, wow. I mean, all my years that I've been with Home of Prayer congregation, wonderful and special things seem to happen. So I'm definitely blessed, and I know if I want to see something happen, all you got to do is do right and have faith. And that's the thing, because I was actually reading some scriptures. I'm going to make this quick. I'm sorry. I'm being talkative. About faith, and I just, for some reason, I just kept seeing a similar thing come up in my reading when it came to, we need to believe. If we believe, then it will happen. Obviously, we have to do right as well, but it was just really speaking to me. Like, I'm not afraid of anything now, but I don't know. It's just like, just believe it. You pray it, believe it, he'll give it to you. And I just kept seeing that recently. And maybe that's a message to me. Maybe that's a message to somebody else. I don't know, but I just keep seeing that pop up for me. So I just hope that if anybody else is praying for something, that if you're doing right, then maybe, and it's still not being answered, maybe it's because we're not believing that he can do it. We're just impatient and want it now. But I want to say that in case anybody is praying and is wanting something done, that we, it's very hard. We must remember to be patient and just know that, you know, if it's taking a long time, more than we thought, then it could be because he has something where it's his timing. And sometimes his timing does take a while. You just have to be really, really patient. Anyway, in this was named, I do ask forgiveness of any sins known or unknown that may prevent these prayers from being heard and answered. I am asking that for all of our children that are in public schools, that you protect them from the teachers that aren't right. There's a lot of teachers that are right, but there's a lot of them that are not right in the head. And some of them just get that job just so they can mess with kids, and that is sickening. The things I've heard and seen. So I'm just asking in each of his name that you also help the kids that are 6 or that are 10, you know, especially around those ages. The teachers will ask them to do something that we know is not correct, but they don't know what's going on. And until somebody tells them, they just think, oh, this is just a game. And then they come home and tell the parents, and the parents are like, oh, my gosh, my child has no idea what has happened to her. So just sad that, you know, I just pray for the little ones to get early discernment, early, 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 because they are doing stuff with kindergartners, they're doing stuff with first graders. It just infuriates me, and it makes me angry, like, look, yes, I believe in homeschool, but I know there are cases where parents cannot, unfortunately, do homeschool because maybe both parents have a job. So I feel bad for those parents because they have to send their kids to school because they can't do it themselves, and they're sending their kids to be educated, not to be molested, not to be doing all this other stuff. And then you even have teachers, and I've dealt with this, where they're impatient. I mean, I've seen stuff where teachers are going off on first graders, like, that's not how we're supposed to count. That's not how we're supposed to do it. Being impatient and embarrassing students. I mean, I've seen this on the internet where they'll say something and they'll humiliate the student in front of all their peers. And I'm like, that's not going to encourage them to learn. We have to be, see, that's where that patience comes from. Nobody wants to be patient. Not even the teachers want to be patient. And I dealt with that. You know, I learned differently. And it got to a point where I was sitting next to my teacher, I think it was fourth grade or something, and she started yelling at me because I didn't know how to solve a problem. And she kept saying, do it over. I just told you this. Why are you not doing this? I've even had my share of that. I saw that today, and it really hit home with me because I haven't dealt with a teacher embarrassing me in front of my peers, but I have had a teacher that had gave my family a very hard time and me a hard time, and it made me not want to do math. It made me not want to learn because I'm like, okay, this teacher's just going to keep being on me. She's just going to keep yelling at me and not be patient with me. So please help the students. Please help the parents, children, and, you know, just really remind the teachers that they need to be patient, that not everybody has the same brain. Not everybody learns the same. So I also ask that if it's that the teachers need more, because I know there's only one teacher and they can't go around the room. I understand that. So, Father, I'm asking that if it's your will, give these teachers more teachers within the room. Give these teachers more supplies. Whatever it is that these teachers, because a lot of our teachers are actually good, but unfortunately, some of them need more to help the students. I'm going to end this. It's sorry if I went out in a rant.
you did. Everything is
right. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you very much. You didn't ramble. You didn't run off. You didn't do all that. You did exactly what the Holy Spirit wanted you to pray. You come on this line to keep us in remembrance of the children, that we don't forget about things that they've experienced in school. And I thank Father for that. I thank you very much. Hallelujah. Anybody else ready? Anybody have a scripture or something you want to read to us?
Hallelujah and good evening.
Hallelujah. Good evening to you, beloved.
All praises to our Most High, who blesses us daily and keeps us on the right path. I just want to thank him. I want to thank him for listening to us when we come to him with our cries and our supplications through the mind and the obedience of Master Yeshua Messiah. Scripture says that we can come to the Father in his name, and that if we obey his commandments and abide in his will, whatever we ask for, we shall receive it. So I come to the Father to thank him for being told how he will honor our requests, how he will honor our cries of distress, because Scripture says he will hear us. And if it is according to his will, he will bless us and acknowledge our petitions. And I just want to thank him for that kindness. I want to thank him for that mercy and that goodness. Because in reality, he doesn't have to do anything for us. He is the creator. He is the highest of the high and the holiest of the holies. And we are subject to him. Many kings and sovereigns rule their people with an iron arm. They only take from their subjects. They do not give. But our most righteous king, he gives back to us. He teaches us. He supports us. He heals us. He helps us. And I have to thank him and the Elohim family for being such a mighty ruler that shows compassion and love upon his people and his subjects. I thank our Heavenly Father for all that he does, for how he listens to us and he supports us. When we have no more strength, he holds us up. When we sin, when we do wrong and come to him and ask for forgiveness, he forgives us. And he continues to love us. And he continues to walk with us, to show us the way, to give us the mind, to walk in obedience to his word, and to show us how to walk upright and in righteousness before him. He is a mighty Elohim who is worthy of all the praise, all the honor, all the reverence, all the blessings upon his name. He is a mighty Elohim who is to be honored and also to be feared, for he is great and he is magnificent. There is no one above him, no one equal to him. And we must remember the power and strength of the Elohim that we serve. He created a world, a rock, for us to live upon. He created the air in which we breathe, the sun that warms the earth, the winds that cool it, the water that refreshes it. He has provided us with all that we need. And he provided us with his guidance and his word. His word that is life in itself. His word that if we abide in it, we live so much more abundantly. He is always walking with us, teaching us, pushing us, and prompting us to do that which is of his will and his word. And I thank him. I thank him that he never gives up on us. He never loses patience with us. He never turns his back on us forever. Yes, he gets angry, but he will still hear our prayers if we pray in sincerity and we pray repentance and we pray in honesty, seeking his face. So I thank him. I just want to say how I love my Heavenly Father and my Master Yeshua Messiah, and may I always have a mind to walk with them, to abide in them and in their word and in their rule. May I always have right ruling over me as stated by the Elohim as to what is right ruling. May I abide in it and it abide in me. I ask and I pray and I thank you in the name of our Master, Yeshua Messiah. And I'm just going to read from Isaiah, Isaiah 41, starting at verse 10. Do not be afraid, for I am with you. Stop being anxious and watchful, for I am your God. I give you strength. I bring you help. I uphold you with my victorious right hand. Yes, all those who raged against you shall be put to shame and confusion. They who fought against you shall be destroyed and perish. You will seek but never find them, those enemies of yours. They shall be destroyed and brought to nothing, those who make war on you. For I, Yahweh, your God, I am holding you by the right hand. I tell you, do not be afraid. I will help you. Do not be afraid, Jacob, poor worm, Israel, puny mite. I will help you. It is Yahweh who speaks, the Holy One of Israel, to your Redeemer, is your Redeemer. See, I turned you into a threshing sled, new with double teeth. You shall thresh and crush the mountains and turn the hills to chaff. You shall winnow them, and the wind will blow them away. The gale will scatter them, but you yourself will rejoice in Yahweh and glory in the Holy One of Israel. And I thank Father for the reading of this word, and I thank him for giving us the picture of him as compared to us, where he calls Israel a puny mite and Jacob a poor worm, but yet he loves us and he takes care of us. And that is why I am so grateful to my Elohim. Amen.
Amen. And we grateful to Father for having created you. Hallelujah for such a time as this and sending all of you all on this line. I thank Father for you blessing him like that. You blessing him, that means more blessing falling upon us or pouring upon us. So thank you very much. Hallelujah. Anybody else ready?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Good evening. I don't, this is not really anything to say, but I just want to say this to Bethany. I really admire hearing you talk in your prayers, because when you speak, I pick up on a sense of her love for children. And I just admire and I just love hearing somebody speak so passionately about the protection of others and the babies and the young ones, because so often we forget about them. At least the people I am around, they don't really acknowledge the children because everyone goes, oh, they're children, they're innocent, you know, they're going to be okay, they're protected, because God, you know, protects the babies and the fools. But the reality is that our children are so susceptible to the dangers and the evil of this world, and I don't normally hear people praying for them. So, Bethany, I just want to say, keep going what you're doing. I love hearing you speak. I love hearing how you bring into what's going on with the younger people. I'm not much older than you, but I've been out of high school, and I've been out of that young adolescent age for a while now. And I just love hearing you keep us in the loop about what's going on and what needs to be prayed for. So a lot of times, hearing Bethany talk about the young children increases my prayers for them, because now I know what to pray for. So, Bethany, I don't know if you're still on the line, but I just wanted to say thank you for your words, and thank you for your wisdom, and thank you for that speech. And I love hearing the love you have for young children and the prayer you have for them. I love hearing it. And I hope that you take that love and you do something with it in the long run to help them. I don't know if it's becoming a principal, running your own school, becoming a social worker, I don't know. But I hope you do something with the love for children, because that's really powerful and that's very special. That's what I wanted to say.
Well, I have to, apparently she didn't gone off the phone. I have to let her know that you said that. And she did start a program, hosting a program for young people, and she had to stop for a while because of school work. And I know she's going to take it up again. I'll let her know. In fact, I'll try to hurry up and do this audio so that she can hear you. So on behalf of her, I thank you so much for sharing that. It'll be encouraging to her as well as the family. Hallelujah. So is there anyone else? There's a couple more people on here. Anybody else? All right. Well, I'll read a couple of scriptures because I know it's past the time, and then we'll be off. Thank you again for those encouraging words. Father, I just want to thank you also for the fact that the teaching that came through on fasting from Minister Williams prompted us to be in this partial or little fast. We call it a little fast, but it's actually a big, big fast in a manner of speaking. But we are doing it together and not like one or two of us without telling the others. We are expecting results because we believe that we heard from you. Hallelujah. Even in Acts 16:31, that word believe. And they replied, believe in Messiah Yahushua and you will be saved, you and your household. We believe when the word came to us, whatever word we heard, we believed to the point where our lives changed. Hallelujah. Our speech changed. We stopped walking the same walk. We stopped dancing to the same songs all the time. Hallelujah. And it also says that, I had a scripture here. Matthew 21:22, if you believe, you will receive whatever you ask for in prayer. That is that word that came about, believe. We believe. It seems so simple that we believe into such a change in our lives. So we're going to keep that word with us as we are fasting. Hallelujah. And Father, I ask, I know that a change is taking place. I also desire for you to let us know if there's something additional you want us to do in this area. Ephesians 1:18-19, I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the people to which he has called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance in his holy people, and his incomparable great power for us who believe. That power is the same as the mighty strength. And we also know that call things that are not as though they were. That's faith. So you have belief, you have faith, and you have hope that never gives up. It just keeps on calling us forth in the strength, Hallelujah. And in the power of the Most High God of Israel. Hallelujah. And then that was, let me see, what else I wanted to, I pulled something else and I had wanted to say it before we get off the line. Now, where is that? Faith and believing and can't find the other word. Father had given me another, it was a fast word. Just a minute. I know it's after the hour. Okay. It's Luke 18, 1 through 12. Then Yahushua told his disciples a parable to show them that they would always pray and not give up. He said, in a certain town there was a judge who neither feared Yahuwah nor cared what people thought. And there was a widow in that town who kept coming to him with plea, grant me justice against my adversary. And what are we praying? We pray that. And we also pray, bless us with financial blessings. Bless us with health. Bless us to communicate with our family. Bless us with wisdom and understanding. We're always talking to Father. Hallelujah. Grant us love. Grant us self-control so we know how to speak to people. Grant us your patience. Grant us your strength. Grant us sweet sleep, as it said in your word. Hallelujah. Grant us the understanding. We don't want to perish if we don't have knowledge. Grant us the knowledge that you give to us. We talk like that all the time. And back to the, what I'm reading from, Luke 18, 1 through 12, for some time, he refused, but finally, I'm at verse 4, he said to himself, even though I don't fear Yahuwah or care what people think, yet because this widow keeps bothering me, and you all, somebody may chuckle here, but I need to keep doing like this widow and say, send me some finances to help me with the ministry. Don't let a whole month and months go by and you don't give. Give here. I need to do that with this. Give, you all. Give what you can. Donate a can of money for a can of milk at least. Don't come in the store and grab all the food and then go out there to arrest you. Maybe I need something like this woman. For those that do help me, y'all know that I am very, very grateful. But I need to talk like this lady. Grant me help so that I can get this, so that the ministry will expand. But first of all, I've been going to Father anyway. Hallelujah. So y'all can do the same. Grant help to your people, please, Father. Grant deliverance to your people, Father. Grant that promotion to your people, Father. Hallelujah. Grant what is needed, Father. So we need to keep doing this all through the day. Grant it, Father. Have mercy where two or more of us are gathered. Hallelujah. Two or more people have been helping me to pray for finances on this line. So I go look at my PayPal. I say, well, ain't nothing there yet. I go look again. I say, well, I hear the prayers, but I don't see the finances. I go look again, and voila, there is something there from people you least expect. This is what tickles me sometimes. It's the people you least expect is the one that look like Father move on. So anyway, keep on telling Father to grant what is needful. And I'm going to do the same thing. I need to open my mouth more to make the needs known, because this is just not by ourselves. Father is granting us results. So Father, go move on our hearts. And I know I'm going to get all the help that I need. Hallelujah. And I'm getting it daily as I go along, trying to perfect those things. Hallelujah, so that they'll get better, meaning responding faster to you all when you want to hear from me or talk with me. Hallelujah. So that word, grant us, hallelujah, what we're asking, Father. Let me finish this, you all, and we'll be off. Verse 5, yet because this widow keeps bothering me, I will see that she gets justice so that she won't eventually come and attack me. And Yahuwah said, listen to what the unjust judge said. Now, this is an unjust man. And will not Yahuwah bring about justice for his chosen ones who cry out to him day and night? Well, I need to cry out more than I've been doing here. Hallelujah. And I thought I was crying a lot. Hallelujah. Wait a minute. And, oh, my goodness. Where am I? And will not God bring about justice for his chosen ones who cry out to him day and night? Will he keep putting them off? I tell you, he will see that they get justice and quickly. However, when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth? To some who were confident of their own righteousness and looked down on everyone else, Yahushua told this parable. Oh, wait a minute. Where did I go here? Where's the lady? Am I still at the lady? Let me see. Well, I'm going to finish this out. Two went up to the temple to pray. One was a Pharisee and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee stood by himself and prayed. Yahuwah, I thank you that I am not like other people, robbers, evildoers, adulterers, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week and give a tenth of all I get. Now, you all know what happened with that. He bragging on himself. But the other one, like us, hitting ourselves on the chest and saying, what else do we need to do? Did we sin? Did we help who we were supposed to? Help us, Father. So here these words are, we fasten for our families. Health to be returned. And not only to be returned, but to go beyond, to be renewed beyond, so they feel even more strength and joy in their bodies. Hallelujah. When this fast is over, that's what we pray. And we, those words came, believe. We are already fasting and we're doing it together so we can talk. This is not one of those secret ones that we do and just don't say anything to anybody because it has to do with what Father doing with us. But this is one that Father doing together. Holler collectively. Now you know he gonna answer our prayers. So Heavenly Father, as we close this off, Father, we praise you. Like just to say thank you, Father. Father, we are so grateful that we are unified in the Spirit. We are so grateful that you brought us into your presence. You bring us into your presence on this line. We know, Father, that you are moving obstacles and things out of our way. We know that you're fighting against the adversary. We know that the angels are on guard. We know that the ministers and angels that call to minister to our needs, like the ministering angels came to the Messiah after he had fasted all that time. I know that you're ministering to us when we see that there is no finances to pay bills. Hallelujah. Not enough money to take care of our families. Some of us are retired and don't have it. Some of us don't know where we're going to get it. We don't know how we're going to do on our jobs. Hallelujah. Because situations have come up. Hallelujah. So we come to the Father and we do not cease. So everybody on the line, don't cease all through the day. Whatever it is we're believing, we are asking, Father, over and over again. That unjust judge got up and gave the widow what she came for, gave her. The justice came about that she was granted there. So we just want to thank Father. Bless Father. Father, I ask you to touch our minds, our hearts, our souls. I ask that you grant whatever is needful that we didn't speak about on this line. We touch and agree according to your will for their hearts. We thank you for those that was praying in their hearts because you see their thoughts. So, Father, bless us going out. Father, we bless you as we go out and come in. Father, bless us going out and coming in. Don't let us forget about you. It's like today, you had me, all of a sudden it came to my head, Father, do the plants talk? Hallelujah, are they talking? Because I know the trees talk. Do the plants talk? Hallelujah. Is all this alive? Yes, it is. Everything alive. And you are running around with this beautiful light around you all and the atmosphere expanding. When we are together, if you could see the huge light that expands around us. I mean, it's not only around us, it's spread out. And the more we come to this line, the more it spreads out, the more, Father, add additional anointing in everything that we are doing. And when the testimonies are coming in, it expands it even the more. And when a hurt one come on this line and they don't know anything about the sound of Father's name that we use on here or the names we use on here, and yet they come back because they're little babies in their heart, and then all of a sudden they begin to get grown because they grow inside because they found a place like a mother away from mother, but a mother that will not hurt them. The King of Kings will not hurt them. that are weak in faith or not strong in faith in this area. He will not, he must be talking to somebody. He will not allow anybody to break your faith and break your action of what you're doing, but rather you're always going to grow in the anointing that he has placed on us. So, Father, thank you for blessing us going out, blessing us coming in. Thank you for blessing us in our beds and blessing us when we get up. Thank you for blessing us when we eat food. Thank you for blessing us when we drink water, eat bread, and you take sickness from out of the midst. We believe that we stand on that. Where two or more gathered in your name, we believe that we stand on it, that you are in the midst of us. When you told us that I've given you power to tread on scorpions, and surface and over all the power of the enemy, help us to understand what those words are saying. That you gave us power is your spirit in us, the power over all the enemy. Then your word says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Help us to understand the majesty of these words, that it is you that is doing this work. We are clothed in Messiah. So Father, thank you. Let your countenance shine upon us. And if there's anything that you want to reveal to any of us to make it better, reveal it, Father, and help us. We yield to you to strengthen us in the areas where we're weak. Help us to be strong. So thank you, Father, for your light being in us. Thank you, Yahushua, for looking at us and saying, now listen, you are my light in the world now. You are my representative in the world now. You are my counsel in this world now. Always yield yourself unto me, because the Holy Spirit in you is going to teach you the way that you should go and what you should say. Hold still when they call you before the judges or whatever, and I will speak. Your Father will speak. You don't you worry about nothing. And he said, don't worry about your children. I told you that all your children will be taught by me. He said it to Israel, we are Israel. If we don't know that we are Israel, we don't know, hallelujah, the meaning of this. We believe he's teaching all of our children. Some of our children are hard-headed. Some of them are not hard-headed. They just don't understand, hallelujah, but he's teaching. So, Father, thank you for lighting up the hearts of our children. And we want to thank you again, Father, for the Prince of Peace. Let your peace rule and reign in all of our homes. We're leaning on you. We're leaning on your everlasting arm. We're leaning on you to carry us. We're leaning on you not to let us fall off into that place of no return, but rather that when we leave these bodies, we'll be headed where you are. And who knows? It may not be up. It may just be right here on heaven. The way you are, heaven just might be right next to us for all I know. I don't know how it works except what I see in a vision. So, Father, bless him. I know I kept him a little bit longer. I thank my sister again for encouraging Sister Bethany. Hallelujah. And I make sure that she gets the encouragement. And I want to encourage all of you on here. Hallelujah. That Father got his hand on all of us. Some of us, he waited 50 years before he got his hands on. Some of us, 30 years, whatever time. He waited until we got it. Hallelujah. He saved us, and then he began to reveal. May y'all have sweet, sweet sleep. Hallelujah. Father, I'm asking that you, again, we're going off. I'm asking that you touch Sharice's body, touch Brian's body, touch Bethany, touch all the rest of us, and that we have sweet sleep when we close our eyes to go to sleep. No heat is going to bother us during the day. So we thank you. Thank you all for being on the line this evening. May Father grant you the request of your heart and your lips according to his will for your life. We touch and agree according to Father's will. Blessings up on you, all of you, and Father loves you fully and perfectly. So thank you, because I love you too. Shalom, shalom, everybody. Hallelujah. Ooh, glory. Hallelujah.
Shalom.
Thank you, Father.
Shalom.